Hello everybody, in today's class we will see the pronunciation of some very common words which we are using daily, but it is really confusing as far as its pronunciation is concerned. In my today's phonetics class, I would like to deal with some words which are similar and confusing. Now you see here these two words, D-I-A-R-Y, D-A-I-R-Y. Pronunciations are different, meanings are different. Now let us see how phonetics will help you to distinguish these two words. So here first word, diary, die, as implied, this diphthong, diary. So first word is diary. Second word is D-A-I-R-Y. Now here you see the diphthong air, as in hair. Diary. So this phonetic symbols will help you to distinguish these two words. Now you see these two words, Q-U-I-T-E. Q-U-I-E-T. So here the difference is this E and T are interchanged. Now let us see how phonetics is useful. Here it is I, this diphthong, I, quiet. This is quiet. There is a difference in these two. This is quiet, this is quiet. Now these two words, career, this pure vowel, career. This final R is silent. This word, career, so only the length is different. Here, as in bad, career. Final R is silent. Similarly, another two words, this is prior, final R is silent, prior, this diphthong is I, prior. This is prayer, here also final R is silent, mostly this R is pronounced in India, but the final R is to be silent. So this is prayer. With these few words, I hope you will understand the importance of phonetics in English learning. Now see this word. It is pronounced hose. Final sound is as in zip. So you know these two words, sip, zip. Here initial sound is different. Here it is a voiced consonant, here it is voiceless consonant. So here final sound is as in zip, so hose. Here another word, only extra letter here is U. It is house, see it changes. Here au, here it is au. So that is the importance of phonetics. Here diphthong, ow, hose. Here it is, ow, house. But this word can be pronounced in two ways. Suppose you are using it as a noun, you have to say house, this is my house. But if it is to be used as a verb, the final sound is as in zib, so house. This building houses 200 workers. So in this case, it is a verb. If you are using it as a verb, we have to say house. Now you see these two words, H-O-R-S-E, H-O-A-R-S-E. Here one extra A is there, but pronunciation is same, horse. this also hoarse, but the meaning is different. Suppose your voice is hoarse, meaning is rough and unpleasant. That's the meaning of this hoarse. Now, these two words. Here one extra H is there. So, it is au, au, this diphthong, au, us. So, it is ending with this sound. Au, au, us. Here, same. Pronunciation is same. Here there is no H, but pronunciation is same. See the first sound, au, as in now, au, us. This word can be pronounced in another way, that is as. Thank you for watching the video. Next time I will come with another interesting topic.